Zotero 7 for Mac. Getting started. What does Zotero do? Here's a quote from the Zotero website. Zotero is a free, easy-to-use tool to help you collect, organize, annotate, cite, and share research. If you've ever lost the best journal article you found for your paper and couldn't remember where or how you found it, or if you ever discovered while doing the bibliography for a paper that some citation information was missing, you will like Zotero. How does Zotero work? As you do your research, Zotero can capture the citation information for each book, journal article, or website you select. It does this by reading the metadata, the embedded information provided with an item. This allows Zotero to capture the information needed to create a citation for any style manual. Let's take a look at Zotero's main screen. Zotero's main screen is divided into three sections or panels. On the left is the organization panel. Here is where you will create collections to hold the items that Zotero captures. Collections is what Zotero calls folders. I've chosen to organize my captured items by classes, but you can do it any way you want. In the middle panel is the library of captured items, or captured citations. This is the ever-growing list of everything you capture with Zotero, arranged alphabetically by title. Tip: never delete a captured item unless you really don't want it anymore. It will disappear from every place it appears in Zotero. On the right is the panel with the citation information and much more about the item that's highlighted in the middle panel. You start off looking at any tags that have been assigned to the item, and these come with the item. You can change them, delete them, rename them, and you can create your own. You also can immediately see which collection this item is in. Here it's my paper for imaginary companions that I'm writing for my Psych 1000 class. There's more information that you can see if you use the slider and go up. You can make notes, you can make attachments, you can do a lot of things here with the toolbar on the right. This journal article came with an abstract or summary. And then finally, up at the very top, we have all of the information for creating a citation. It's a good practice to check each citation for accuracy after you capture it. You can easily jump to the top of the information in the right panel by clicking on the info icon. Let me show you. Here's another item. And I want to go up to the citation information, so I click and go straight up. Let's start a new project. In the left-hand panel, I'm going to create a collection. And this is going to be for my history class. Now, I'm going to be doing two papers for the history class. So I'm going to create another collection inside this one for the first paper that I have to work on. So with this highlighted, I click again, and now I can enter a name for this collection. The topic of my paper is chocolate or cacao in ancient Mesoamerica. And now that this collection is highlighted, everything I capture will go in here. And I'll have everything that I need for my paper. If I forgot to highlight the exact collection that I wanted things to go into, I could drag and drop them from the middle panel, the library of captured citations. Remember, Zotero always needs to be open while you do your research, or you won't be able to capture anything. Now I'm ready to start the research for my paper. Watch the other videos in this series to see Zotero in action, capturing citations, creating in-text citations, and creating a bibliography. Don't miss the library's written and illustrated guide to Zotero 7 for Mac at libguides.csusb.edu/maczotero. It has a detailed overview of Zotero 7's basic functions. And if you want to go beyond the basic functions, go to zotero.org/support to start exploring. The end. Thank you for watching.